never treat you right. I wanna love you every day and every night. We'll be together with a roof over our head. We'll share the shelter of my single bed. Is this love? Is this love? Is this love? Is this love that I'm feeling?
Give this speech without first acknowledging the wonderful woman that was there to bring these three girls up. Allison first, then Kelly, then Lauren. Sandy was a proud mama. She was able to be at Allison's wedding, and she was able to see the birth of her first two grandchildren, Griffin and Kylie. Unfortunately, she wasn't there for Kelly's wedding. It's not going to be there for Kelly's first grandson. But she's here. She's here with us all. There's nothing she wanted more than to be here for all her kids' weddings and for all her grandkids to be born. But she's here with us, I guarantee.
I wanna love you. Wanna just love and treat you right. I wanna love you every day and every night, and we'll be together with a roof over our head. We'll share the shelter of my single bed. And is this love? Is this love? Is this love? Is this love that I'm feeling? And is this love?
Best friend and one of the most thoughtful and loving women I know. I don't want to think of enough life without you, and I'm so thankful we found each other so early on. There isn't anyone I'd rather spend my life with. I'm so thankful every day over the past 10 years we've been able to grow emotionally and physically and spiritually together. I cannot thank you more for that. Lauren, you are my soulmate, and I believe in 1,000 different lifetimes we'd always find our way back to each other. I'm so thankful for you in endless ways. I promise to protect you, to be loyal to you, and to cherish it. I also promise to help us raise our family and provide the only way I know how to. I love you no matter the condition. You are all I want in life. I love you.
Dear Kyle, not many people can say they found their soulmate when they were just 16. You are my first and now my forever love, and I couldn't be luckier. It's crazy to think we've almost been together longer than we've been apart. I know that meeting you is no coincidence. As cliche as it sounds, I firmly believe God placed you in my life when he did, knowing that I need your endless love and support sooner rather than later. You were my rock when my mom passed, a calm during my storm, and showed me at such a young age what true love looked like. I am and will always be grateful for that. We then graduated high school and college, bought our first home, and started to build our own little family with our dog. No matter what obstacle has been thrown our way throughout our journey, we have always managed to figure it out together. There are so many things that I have grown to love about you. I love how loyal and driven you are. I love that you always put me first and have made me a priority since the start. I even love your dry, sarcastic humor because it makes me such a great I'm not quite sure where I would be without your impeccable cooking skills and your willingness to do the laundry, or your natural fatherly instincts to help raise the dog. I would simply be lost without you. So now I would like to make a few promises. I promise to never stop supporting you on anything you put your mind to, whether that be a job, a trip, or even just your next tattoo. I promise to continue to learn about you, about your likes and dislikes. I promise to roll over easily when I'm snoring and to never stop laughing with you. I promise to do my best to communicate and be the best version of myself in order to be the best version. I know that I am one of the most indecisive humans ever, but choosing to love you has been the easiest decision I've ever made. Thank you for loving me so well. These last 10 years. I can't wait for the next 50 with the dog and I love you so much.
It's my honor to declare you husband and wife. Kyle, you may kiss your bride.
I wanna love you.
Mr. and Mrs. Pudlowskis.